What if you were the person that discovered a species no one even knew existed? What would you name it? What do you think this new species would mean to science?
Where I'm standing is the place where hundreds of scientists from all over the world come to explore different life forms here in the Great Smoky Mountains National Park. So far, over 1,000 species new to science have been discovered here.
This project is called the All Taxa Biodiversity Inventory, the ATBI for short. This project has been going on for over 20 years and over 10,000 species have been studied that before we had no idea were in the park. Even with all the work that's already been done, we still think there are between 40 and 60,000 species that haven't even been discovered yet.
When you think of Great Smoky Mountains National Park, what kinds of animals do you think of? Bear? Elk? Salamander? Park ranger?
Those are the stars of the Smokies, and they're super important. But what if I told you that these guys are what make it possible for us to have animals in the park? These are called terrestrial macroinvertebrates.
Terrestrial macroinvertebrate what? Are you talking about aliens?
No. Terrestrial, meaning land or earth. Macro, which means the opposite of micro, which means it's big enough to see without a microscope. And the last part, invertebrate, which means it doesn't have a spine. Some examples of macroinvertebrates are beetles, worms, spiders, and
snakes.
Actually, snakes do have a backbone. But that's a lesson for another day.
Did you get it?
Hey, Ranger Becca. Hey, Ranger Natrafia.
Hey, Izzy.
Are you guys collecting bugs again?
Yeah, we sure are.
How come y'all are so obsessed with those things?
Well, when you think back to the stars of the Smokies, they're really important to them. So the salamanders like to eat all kinds of terrestrial macroinvertebrates. The bears are really partial to the grubs and the larvae of some of them. The elk really love to eat the grass, which comes from healthy soil. And do you know what makes healthy soil?
Is it terrestrial macroinvertebrates?
You're
nailed
right.
It. Yeah, and Izzy too, when we monitor terrestrial macroinvertebrates over long periods of time, it kind of gives us a big picture of what's going on in the park. So these organisms, when we look at their diversity, their abundance, we can tell what things are affecting them. So maybe it's pollution or climate change. If we look at that data over time, we get a better picture of what's going on in the park as a whole.
Yeah, and so that's why we like to call these things bioindicators. And so if we can show that the diversity or the abundance of these bioindicators is changing over time, that can be kind of a check engine light to what's going on in our ecosystem, which helps us better protect and preserve our resources. So do you want to help us see what more we can find out here?
Yeah, that sounds great.
Awesome, thanks, Izzy, let's go.
We're standing here at one of our data collection sites where we're going to be collecting for 12 minutes here in this standard plot. The reason that we use these consistent variables is so that we can monitor accurate change over time.
Yeah, so we'll be looking in the leaf litter or the duff for our macroinvertebrates. And we'll also check out the humus layer of the soil, which is kind of that top layer down here. We can look under rotting logs or rocks and find our macroinvertebrates. So we'll set the clock for 12 minutes and we'll start collecting our data.
Now that we've collected our samples, it's time to go back to the lab and do our inventory. So we'll see you all there.